Now to a possible milestone in the pursuit of clean energy. Here's what the Washington Post is reporting, and Financial Times as well, that scientists have made a major breakthrough using nuclear fusion, with the Energy Department set to make a big announcement tomorrow. And for that, CNN's chief climate correspondent, Mr. Bill, he's doing his own.
Hi, Don.
Sound effects here. He's rolls. Here with us.
So, you deserve it.
Good morning to you. I guess so. Let's see how he gets through this. But this, I mean, it's fascinating. Look, this fusion thing that people have been, it's been so hard to achieve, and how it could change the game for the climate crisis.
Yes. This is the holy grail of energy. Imagine a glass of water fueling your house for hundreds of years with no waste, cheaply, renewably. This is what they've said is just a decade away, and always will be, is the joke about nuclear fusion. Fission that we are familiar with splits atoms and creates all the nuclear waste that we know about. Fusion jams them together by basically creating a star in a box. You're creating the power of the sun, and you're using hydrogen atoms, water, H2O, right? And smashing them together. And up until now, the conventional way to do this was to use these massive magnets, magnets that are big enough literally to lift an aircraft carrier.
Wow.
But the Lawrence Livermore laboratory, they decided to use lasers. And so they're heating up this hydrogen plasma, making it so hot that the reaction creates more energy than you put in. And so this could be a major breakthrough, Secretary Granholm expected to announce tomorrow.
The question is commercial use, though, right?
Yeah.
When is it going to be something that's...
It could be decades
you can actually see it light.
Away. It could be decades away, but... You know, it's one of those things where you think nothing's going to happen, and then something happens, and then it's all at once, right? And you're going past.
Decades isn't that long.
It's not that long, and we're on the cusp
for
of
this.
And there's other pathways to this that could have even bigger breakthroughs. But I think the bigger sense is the lead into this story was another pipeline.
That's
leak,
just what I was thinking.
Right?
Like, this doesn't have spills like that.
Right, exactly.
But and there are implications to the business.
Of course. There's trade-offs for everything, right, for wind and solar and all of those, but you're looking for the least horrible options. And it's obvious that depending on the fuels that leak and burn is what got us into this climate crisis. And the closer we can get this to a better future, the faster, the better.
You were saying that you were looking at water powering your home and...
It's the hydrogen atoms that's in a glass of water is the fuel source for this.
I kept thinking from a family who grew up with two parents who worked for Exxon, oil and chemical plants. So they must be saying, wait, what the heck is this all about? Are they happy about it? They're not.
Well, I mean, anything that challenges the status quo business models, that's the most profitable industry ever. But the smart ones will probably get behind these new transitions, right? And this is just one factor of a whole new, I'm working on a special on this now, these ideas of things that are, everything you can see in your physical world will have to be reinvented in some way or another.
Wow.
Energy sources, how you clothe and feed and shelter your children, everything is changing in the most dramatic ways coming forward. This could be major. This could be like a Wright Brothers moment for energy tomorrow if they confirm this happened.
Yeah, we'll see what Secretary Granholm says in her announcement. Bill Weir, thank you, as always.
The future is now. Like, we looked at all those movies from, in the future, right, when we were kids, and now we're living in that.
Is it here?
Yeah. Good to see you.
Thanks, Bill.
See you,
bud.